everyone, and welcome to my channel. So today we're going to make the world's easiest chocolate fudge ever, and we'll use only three ingredients for it. First off, we will obviously need some chocolate, and for that I'm using the Amul bitter 90% dark chocolate. You're of course free to use any chocolate of your choice. We'll also need some sweetened condensed milk, and today I'm using Nestle Milkmaid. Amul's Mithai Mate works equally well. And I would also recommend putting a few drops of vanilla essence to add in an element of, surprise to the final outcome. We start off with greasing the dish we will use to set the fudge in, and then place some baking paper or wax paper or even aluminum foil. Skipping these and just going with the greased dish will not work, and your fudge will actually just stick to the dish and refuse to even come out. Now to start with the actual recipe, chop your chocolate into small pieces. This will ensure that your chocolate melts quickly and evenly without burning. I would recommend getting your chocolate softened by taking it out of the fridge, say about half an hour before you set to make your fudge, I obviously did not do that, and hence I'm having a really hard time chopping here. You can see the struggle. The struggle is real, people. Next, take a saucepan, put the chopped chocolate into it, and put the saucepan on low heat. Keep stirring continuously to prevent burning the chocolate. If you're nervous doing so, you can also melt your chocolate on a double burner, that is, heat water in a pan, and while it is still on the burner, put your pan of chocolate on it. Obviously, I like to live on the edge and hence have my chocolate directly over the flame. Stir, stir, stir. Stirring is the key to this easy peasy recipe. Trust me. Once your chocolate is melted completely into this glossy and shiny looking delicious mess, add in half of this sweetened condensed milk and continue stirring. You're in dangerous territory, people, and your chocolate can burn any instant, so stir that mixture really well. Of course, if you're on a double burner, this is not going to happen to you. Now I'm adding in the remaining half of the condensed milk and will continue stirring. On a related note, did you as a child eat Milkmaid directly from the tin? Oh my god, I still do, and I totally love Milkmaid. Anyways, coming back, you'll know your fudge mixture is ready when it turns glossy and liquidy again. Once it has become like a nice homogeneous mixture, take your pan off the heat and keep it on a cool surface. Immediately add about half a teaspoon of vanilla essence and give the fudge mixture a good stir yet again. Our liquid fudge is now ready, and we will transfer it to a prepared setting dish. Now I have to warn you that the fudge will start to set immediately and can get very sticky. And hence you have to work very quickly here. As is evident, I had a hard time here, and I have not been able to hide it even with the editing. Once your fudge is in the dish, give the dish a couple of taps by thudding it on the counter. I'm not sure how to put it, do this particular action that I'm doing. And cover it and let it set in a corner of your kitchen for about 3 to 4 hours. If you live in a cold place, then good for you. But if you're in a warmer place, then you will have to place your dish in the refrigerator overnight, preferably after letting it set for 3 hours at room temperature. Okay, so this is literally the next morning. I have taken my fudge out of the fridge, and now I'm struggling to take it out of the pan. Of course. Okay, the struggle is still on. Okay, finally it's out. Yay. And I just have to peel off the parchment paper now. and it's out. All right, ah, such a beautiful block of chewy, chocolatey goodness. You can now chop them up any way you want, cut them in bars or small candy sized blocks. You can also wrap them up in baking or wax paper. Okay, so that's it for the easiest recipe for chewy and ultra rich chocolate fudge. Do try it out at your end, guys, and let me know how they turned out. So until then, thank you for watching. Please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and I will see you soon.